Montana's Best Country, 100.7 KXLV. That's Brad Paisley. 7:53, your XL Morning Show, and we're excited to have the new basketball coach for the MSU Bobcats in studio with us today, Brian Fish. Brian, seriously, I know you're busy and you got all kinds of things going on. We appreciate you taking the time to come in this morning.
Oh, it's fun to be here. It's fun to sell the Montana State Bobcats. And it's just, like I said, this has been fun to do. So having a great time.
So, okay, so I've got 10 random questions for you that we're going to throw at you here.
Let me ask you this. I don't have to score a certain score. This ain't like an SAT because I might not be eligible.
No. There is no wrong or right answer, actually.
Well, that's what they always tell you, and then they never invite you back.
So we'll see how it goes here. Maybe after five we'll just quit.
Yeah.
So, all right, first one. We're a country station. You're in Montana now. Can you name three country artists?
Yeah. Blake Shelton. Tim McGraw, and let's see here, Taylor Swift.
Boom! All right, had to think about it a little bit though.
I grew up with John Mellencamp in my small town, so I'm kind of more towards the rock because I grew up in the same town as him.
What's your anniversary with your wife?
June 5th.
Look at that! Didn't hesitate at all. Year?
It'll be 16 years ago this June 5th.
All right. You confident on that?
Yeah.
Is she listening right now?
Probably so.
Okay. All right. Most famous basketball player that you've ever met?
Oscar Robinson.
Oh, that's a big one. Very nice. You ever met Michael Jordan?
Yes, I have.
Yeah? All right. Mexican food or Italian food?
Tex-Mex.
Tex-Mex. Okay. Look at that. I can't even read my writing on this question, so you don't get it. Last book you read?
I just finished Colin Cowherd's book about
ESPN
book. It was entertaining.
All right, I'm going to send him this video that we're shooting right now.
Please do, because the one after that was Hoosiers, I think.
Is that right?
Years ago, so I feel pretty good I've read a book.
So, you're from Indiana. This isn't even on the list. I'm doing impromptu right now. You're from Indiana. The movie Hoosiers, is that a representation of what it's really like for basketball in Indiana?
It was till they went to the class system. Now the class system has separated it. Where I grew up, our high school gym was the third largest in the country of 8,000 seats for a high school gym. When I was a kid, we used to go there, and what really got me hooked as a kid was we used to have to go, and there would be a raffle to get season tickets of 8,000. Our town was 18,000 people. And they sold 8,000 season tickets, and you had to go through a raffle to get tickets to even go to the games.
And that's high school basketball.
That's high school basketball.
That's crazy. So you just came here from the University of Oregon.
Correct.
Which is in Eugene, which is where they filmed Animal House. Have you ever been to the Animal House?
Yeah, it kind of was a stop on the way. It's, my 4 years at Oregon, first 2 years you could only bring the kids in, and you'd drive by and kind of tell them about Animal House, and they were looking for Will Ferrell or something like that type of movie. And then the last 2 years, you were allowed to bring parents in. When you drove by and showed them the house where Animal House, they wanted to pull over and take pictures of it. So it's kind of funny how the time in recruiting's changed in the 4 years at Oregon.
Like, kids now, they're like, Animal House? What's
yeah.
that?
No, they don't even know. And it's unbelievable.
All right, final question for you. This came from a listener earlier today, not from me. I just want you to know.
All right.
Boxers or briefs?
Briefs. So, yeah, trying to think what I had on.
All right. Hey, at least he had an answer to it, right?
Yeah.
All right, it's the new head basketball coach at MSU. It's Brian Fish, and we're excited to have you in town. And seriously, thank you so much for coming in. I hope this won't be the last time that you come by.
Oh, please have me back. I love it. I appreciate the support and come out to some games. And like I said, great to be here and just fun to be in Bozeman.